Hello friends, welcome to my video. Today's video is about single row functions in Oracle. So let us first see what is a function. A function is a small program that performs something and returns a result. Single row functions operate on single row of data and return a single value. They can appear either in select clause, where clause, order by or having clauses. They are text functions. We have text functions, we have numeric functions, date functions, etc. in Oracle. So in this video, we are going to discuss the text functions. Some of the examples of the text functions are like a substring. Then we have upper, lower, INITCAP, length function, CONCAT, replace, translate and in string function. So we'll just discuss in detail about these text functions in this video. So let's move to the next video. So the first function which we are going to discuss is the substring function. The substring function returns a portion of the string. This is tags as like the substring function, and where we provide the input string, the position and the substring length. So let's see few examples. We can see here I have used a substring function. Here is my input string, that is how are you. This is a position, that is I have given the position, like the position from which I want to pick up my substring. And then this is this sixth position, like I want six characters to be picked up. So how it's like, if let me count from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it starts from A, this is the fifth position, and up to 6 characters I want my substring to be. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it's coming till O. And the value is printed as R, U. So next example is, I have just given the position, I have not given the length of the string. So in this case, what will happen, it will start counting from the third character, that is this W in our case, and up to the end, end of the string, because I have not defined how many characters of the string I want to print. Second is, I have provided the position as a negative value, that is -7, and up to a characters of 5. So what will happen here, Oracle will start counting backwards. If you can see, this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, it will start from A, okay, and it will count 5 characters after it. That is, if you can see, it will come till Y, okay. The same is printed here in value 3. Next, if I provide a position, I have provided a position here as 2, but the length of the string I haven't provided is 0, then in this case Oracle will return a null value, because this length of the string should be a positive number, should be greater than 0. Similarly, if you can see, if I provide a negative number here as well, the value returned is null. Okay, I hope this is clear. Let's move to the next function. So here are some other common functions which we use. If you know that this is upper function, the syntax is upper, where we provide the input string, it will convert all the input string characters into uppercase. Similarly, the lower case will convert all those characters of the input string into lowercase. INITCAP, it also has the same syntax, but it will return the string with the first letter of each word in uppercase and all the rest in lowercase. The length function returns the length of the string. The concat function, it's used to add two or more strings together. If you see, the syntax is concat, the first string and the second string. So we can, instead of this concat function, we can also use this OR operator. If you can, with the first string here and the OR operator and the second string, this can also be used. And mostly we use this because concat function, we cannot concat more than two or some strings, but using this OR operator, right, we can concat a number of strings together. Let me move to the next function. The next text function which we are going to discuss is replace function. The replace function returns the string with every occurrence of search string replaced with the replacement string. So here the syntax is we provide input string here, the search string which we want to search, and the replacement string. So we'll replace the search string with the replacement string using this replace function. Let's see a few examples. So if you can see, the first is I have entered my string, how are you. I have this search string which I want to search in this input string, and this is a replacement string. So here I want to search for R and I want to replace it with ABC. So if you can see, R is replaced with ABC. If you see next example, here I have provided the search string but I didn't provide the replacement string. So what will happen in this case? If the replacement string is omitted or null, then all the occurrence of the search string, that is R, will be removed from this input string. You can see R is removed here. You can see the next example. So here I have provided the search string as ABC. I didn't provide any replacement string, but here, as in our case, this search string is not present in the input string, so the input string is returned as whatever it was original. Next example is I have provided the search string as null and I have provided the replacement string. So as in our case, the search string is null, the input string itself is returned. You can see the value 3 and 4, the input string itself is returned. Let's move to another function. The next text function which we are going to discuss is the translate function. This is similar, we can say, to replace function, but replace function replaces a search string with a replacement string, okay? And but in translate, it is slight difference is that it will return the expression with all occurrences of each character. Okay, it is each character in the from string replaced by the corresponding characters in the to string. Okay, so if you can see the syntax, we have translate here. I'll be providing the original string here. This is the from string. You can say this like from string is like the search characters, like the characters which I want to search for, and to string like the number of the characters which I want to replace with. Okay, so if you can see, replace lets you substitute a single string for another single string as well as remove character strings, right? Translate lets you make several single character one-to-one substitutions in one operation. Okay, we'll see a few examples. So you can see the first example here, I have my input string here as do you like apples. This is my you can see the search character string, and this is the replace character string. So here what I have entered here in the search is, like you can see in within this single quotes, space is there, a small character e is there, and a question mark is there. And so what will happen, every occurrence of this space will be replaced with this underscore. Okay, every occurrence of small e will be replaced with capital E, and every occurrence of this question mark will be replaced by plus. Okay, if you can see the result string, it's the value is displayed here. In next example, I have provided this search character string, but this replacement string I have kept it blank. What will happen, you cannot use this empty string for to string to remove all characters in the from string. So we cannot use this empty string to remove the characters. So what the value will be returned will be null. Okay, next is we want to like remove few characters from a string, right? Then what we have to do, we have to concat, like in this search character string, right? Then the beginning of the search character string, we have to provide a character, the same character we have to provide at our this replacement character string as well. So here the character which I have used is underscore. Okay, this is common to our this to string and the from string as well. So what it will do, like now it will remove all occurrences of p and e from this input string. Okay, you can see from this the value 3, the result, the occurrences of P and E are removed. I have used a similar example again. If you can see, we can use any character. Okay, Now here I had used this underscore, and here I have used the character F, which is common here in this search string as well as a replacement string. So what will happen, all the occurrences of S and K will be removed from this our original string. Okay. Next example is I want to replace like Y, K, S. Okay, so I want to replace Y with 4. Okay, Y will be replaced, all the occurrences of Y replaced with 4, K is replaced with 2, and S. As for S, I haven't provided any character replacement here, so all the occurrences of S will be removed from this result string. Okay. I think it's fine. Let's move to the next function. This is the INSTR function. So this returns a position in which one string is found within another string. So the syntax is INSTR function. We have the original string here, the substring, the position, and the occurrence of it. There is another similar function, that is INSTR, which returns the location of a string in a string using bytes instead of character. If you can see, the syntax is almost similar. Let's move to few examples. Now if you can see, I have this string here, welcome here, where I want to get the position of this character, that is R. So what is the position of R here? You can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, 11th character is R, so 11 is returned here. Next, we want to search the position of this character E, starting from the 8th position. Okay, so this is the 7th, this is the 8th position. After this, I need to count the position of E. Okay, so we won't count this E, this is the other 7th position, we'll count after it. So it's the 8th position. After 8, next position is 9, this is 10th. Okay, this is the second occurrence of E, that is at the 10th position, so it returns 10 here. Now if we want to count the position of E here after 8 characters, and this should return the second position of E. So if you can see, after E, after this H, which is the second position of E, which is this one, right, the last E, and it is what, it's 12 here, right? So it will return 12 in this result. Now I have a negative example here. Now if I want to find the occurrence of E, I have provided a negative number, is -3. It will start counting backwards from till -3, and then this is 2, right? This is the second position after this third, right? The second position of E it will count. So let's count backward. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3. 3 is this E here, right? After this R, this E is a third position. So this is the first position of E, but we want to get the second position. So we'll move again here, right? So this is the second position of E. Now how INSTR will count it? It will count from here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It will return the 7 as the result, which is the second position of E from backwards. Okay, and similarly, if we use the INSTR function also, it's similar, but it's also written the same value here. We can't see any difference here, but this returns the location of a string using bytes instead of characters. Hope this video was useful. Thank you.